Oh, it's so great to see you. It is great to be here in Oakville today to talk about our plan to build more housing here in the GTA and right across the country. So glad to be here, obviously, with our Minister of Housing, Sean Fraser, mais aussi d'autres membres de notre équipe, la ministre Karina Gould, Anita, Pam, Adam, and the entire team of municipal leaders who are here with us, particularly Halton Regional Chair Carr. Thank you so much for being here as well. Halton mayors and councillors, thank you for being part of this, because we don't get things built unless we work together. And that's why we're gathered here today, because we all take the need for more housing options so seriously. Last week, we released our budget, which is all about fairness for every generation, especially Gen Z and millennials. Younger generations are worried that regardless of how hard they work, how many side hustles they get, it looks like they won't have the kind of life that they saw their parents and grandparents able to give them. Avant, quand les gens travaillaient fort et avaient un bon emploi, ils pouvaient s'offrir un logement. Mais aujourd'hui, les logements sont rendus juste trop chers. Il faut que les choses changent. Il faut s'attaquer à la crise du logement avec ambition, et c'est exactement ce qu'on est en train de faire. If we want to make homes more affordable, we need to build more of them. And that's exactly what we're doing. Our housing plan will deliver almost 3.9 million homes in the coming years. And an important part of this plan that we're going to talk about today is the use of public lands. We're making a historic shift in our approach to public lands that will unlock 250,000 new homes for Canadians by 2031. And to convert these public lands to housing, we'll be using all the tools available, and we'll be partnering with home builders and housing providers. See, right now, governments across Canada are sitting on surplus, underused, and vacant public lands, like empty office towers or low-rise buildings. There is great potential to build more housing, but we all have to step up, all of us together. As part of our work with municipal, provincial, and private sector partners, we will launch a $500 million public lands acquisition fund so we can purchase land from other levels of government and build more middle-class homes. En libérant des terrains publics pour construire des logements, les gouvernements peuvent réduire les coûts de construction et bâtir plus de logements plus rapidement à des prix que les Canadiens peuvent se permettre. Another thing we'll do is lease public lands instead of selling them off wherever we can. Leasing public lands to partners means that public lands stays public, and an affordable home, therefore, will stay affordable. I think that's something that every level of government can get behind. Le gouvernement fédéral possède beaucoup de propriétés et de terrains. Par exemple, des propriétés de Postes Canada, des terrains de la Défense nationale et des bureaux fédéraux sous-utilisés. On doit utiliser ces terrains pour mieux servir les Canadiens en aidant à construire plus de logements. Canada Post, for example, has more than 1,700 post offices across the country, many of them in central locations in their communities. We could build homes or apartments on top of these offices that meets the needs of communities while maintaining the services Canadians expect. On national defense properties that are not required for defense operations, we can build affordable housing and prioritize the needs of members of the Canadian Armed Forces and their families. Work is already underway with the Department of National Defense to unlock 14 surplus properties for homes. Now, it's not how previous governments used to do things, but it's not rocket science either. Over the past years, our government has unlocked over 10,000 homes on public land. Ce ne sera pas facile de régler la crise du logement, mais avec des solutions audacieuses et responsables, on va y arriver tous ensemble. Now, I've spent the last few weeks talking with Canadians, the couple who's expecting their second child and needs an extra room, the workers who deal with long commutes every day to go into work, the students who can't afford to pay for a rent that just keeps increasing. Canadians need homes they can afford. This is one of the most urgent issues that people are facing. And we made a promise to Canadians that we were going to solve this housing crisis, and using public lands to build more homes is a big part of our plan. Mais on va aussi aider les locataires à améliorer leur code de crédit. On travaille avec les municipalités pour éliminer la paperasse et accélérer la construction de logements. On contribue à bâtir plus d'appartements, de coopératives et de logements supervisés à travers le pays. We're working hard every day to make housing more affordable so that every generation has a fair chance to succeed.